So guys, with the select statement, the first thing we need to understand is the syntax rules. What are the syntax rules for the select statement? So the first rule with the select statement is that there is no syntax rule. That means whether you write it in uppercase, lowercase, it generally does not matter. Your command will definitely be executed. Let us see an example for same and then we'll proceed further. So this command, I will write it in lowercase, select star from hr.employees, and let us run this command. Okay, looks like the database connection is reset. So guys, you might see this same issue while you're working. I think there is a bug with this SQL developer version. So let the error come in and then I'll talk about it. So very frequently your connection might get disconnected if there is no activity in the SQL developer. I tried to work on this bug. You see this one, your database connection has been reset. So just click on OK and then it will try to reconnect the database. Later on you can run your query. Okay, now do you see, even if you write your query in the uppercase, or if you write your query in the lowercase, or if you write your query in the mixed case also, so let me try to do it, SELE select star from hr.employees. Now what happens when you write your query in mixed case? Okay, I have all uppercases, lowercases, still your query will give the output. Now in this case, what is the syntax rule? The syntax rule says that you can use any case when it comes to your query. Okay, you can use any case with your queries. Now in this syntax rules, there is definitely another rule where it says your conditions that you specify in your SQL statement, they must be specific. Okay, so right now I won't go on to that, or I won't show that result immediately, but in some time when we are working with the where clause, I will talk about it. So don't worry, but let me write it. When you specify conditions, be specific about the case. Okay, now for example, you want to select all the employees with the name Arun. Now inside your database, you need to be specific, like how the name has been stored inside the database. Is the name stored all in lowercase? Is the name stored all in uppercase? Or it is capitalized case, nothing but A is capital and rest all is lowercase. Now in such situations, when you are selecting the data, when you want to specify a condition, you need to be very specific about the case. So your query, like your keywords or the default keywords of a query, can be of any case. But when you specify a condition, when you want to select data from a table, then you need to be very specific about the conditions, nothing but the case. Is it uppercase? How the data is stored? You need to give the almost exact value. Okay, so I'll come back to this point when we are working in the where conditions. So for now, the syntax rules for the select statement is there is no case. You can use any case with your query, but for your conditions, you need to specify the case, and all queries must end with a semicolon or a slash. This is again very important. If you try to run your queries without semicolon or without slash, then it might be a problem. Can you see table or view does not exist because you did not put, oh sorry, I think in this case, of course, that table is not available. I'm sorry. Let us run this query. So this should run perfectly well, and without semicolon, let us try to run this query. So guys, in SQL Developer, definitely you might get an output. Let us delete everything and we'll keep only this statement and try to run this. Yes, so in SQL Developer, you might get output even without a semicolon. That is the efficiency of the tool. But when you're working with SQL Star Plus or inside the database, then make sure every statement ends with a semicolon or a slash. So definitely slash also works. For example, like select star from hr.employees and then you put a slash at the end and you run it, the command should run fine. Can you see? So if you have multiple line codes, generally people use slash. I mean, it's not something that you have to use. You can use a semicolon also and run it. It will work perfectly fine. Don't use both at the same time. That's why I have written or. So either you use this or you use slash. Now these are the syntax rules for the select statement. Very critical, you should know about the syntax rule.